My name's Dr. James O'Donovan, and together we're going to be covering key things you need to know about a medication called metoprolol, a type of medicine known as a beta blocker that is most often used to treat high blood pressure. You might also know metoprolol by its brand names Lopressor and Toprol XL. Now, it works by slowing down your heart rate, and it makes it easier for your heart to pump blood around your body. It can also be prescribed by your doctor if you've got an irregular heartbeat and to prevent chest pain caused by a condition called angina. Occasionally, it can also be used to prevent migraines and reduce your symptoms if you've got too much thyroid hormone in your body. Now, during your first 12 months on this medicine, you'll normally be offered a couple of routine tests to make sure that your liver is working properly. In this video, we're going to cover a couple of key things about this medication. First of all, who can and can't take it, how and when to take it, side effects, potential interactions with other medications, and finally, some common questions that I'm often asked and where to find out more information. So first of all, let's take a look at who can as well as can't take it. Well, most adults and children can take metoprolol. However, like all medicines, it's not suitable for everyone. Now, to make sure that it's safe for you, you should tell your doctor if you've ever had an allergic reaction to metoprolol or any other medication, if you have low blood pressure or a slow heart rate, if you've got lung or liver disease or severe asthma, if you've got a condition called metabolic acidosis, which is when there's too much acid in your blood, if you've got an overactive thyroid, and that's because metoprolol may make it more difficult to recognize the warning signs of having too much thyroid hormone in your body, or if you've got a circulation problem, such as Raynaud's disease or Raynaud's syndrome, which may make your fingers or toes tingle or turn pale or blue, although this may be less obvious on black skin. So now let's cover how and when you should take metoprolol. Well, metoprolol comes as tablets with strengths of 50 milligrams and 100 milligrams, and how much of it you're going to take will depend on why you need it. Now, this will vary from person to person, but in general terms, I'll put a table of common doses for each condition up on screen now. So typical doses for high blood pressure are 50 milligrams to 100 milligrams taken twice a day. For chest pain, 50 milligrams to 100 milligrams taken 2 to 3 times a day. For an irregular heartbeat, 50 milligrams taken 2 to 3 times a day. And for preventing a migraine, 50 milligrams to 100 milligrams taken twice a day. For people who've got too much thyroid hormone or thyrotoxicosis, 50 milligrams taken 4 times a day is the typical dose. Now, obviously, the doses will vary from individual to individual, so it's really important to take the dose that has been prescribed to you by your own health provider. Now, in terms of practically how to take it, you can take metoprolol with or without food. It's important to swallow the tablets whole with a drink of water, and some tablets have got a score line to help you break them in half to make it easier to swallow. And you should check the information leaflet for your brand to see if you can do this. Now, your doctor may advise you to take your very first dose before bedtime because it can make you feel dizzy. If you don't feel dizzy after having your first dose, you can take metoprolol in the morning. Finally, if you have metoprolol more than once a day, try to space the doses evenly throughout the day. Now, in terms of how long you need to take it for, treatment with metoprolol is usually long-term, possibly even for the rest of your life. Stopping metoprolol suddenly can make your condition worse. So talk to your doctor first if you're thinking about doing this. And like for all medications, if you've been taking it for a long time, it's important to have a review of all your medications with your physician or doctor once a year to make sure to see if you need to continue taking it. If you're bothered by any of the side effects, your doctor might be able to prescribe a different medication for your health issue. Now, if you do stop taking metoprolol, it will take 1 to 2 days for it to be completely out of your body. It's also important that I mention that you should continue to take metoprolol even if you feel better, because if you suddenly stop taking it, your symptoms could worsen. Now, what should you do if you accidentally forget to take it? Well, if you miss a dose, take your metoprolol as soon as you remember, unless it's nearly time for your next dose. If this happens, just leave out the missed dose and take your next dose at the usual time. Never take 2 doses at the same time, and never take an extra dose to make up for a forgotten one. On the other hand, what should you do if you accidentally take too much? Well, the amount of metoprolol that can lead to an overdose varies from person to person. Taking too much metoprolol can slow down your heart rate and make it quite difficult to breathe. It can also cause dizziness and trembling. So if you take too much by accident and you're experiencing any negative side effects, speak to your health provider. In terms of side effects, metoprolol, like any medicine, can cause side effects, but many people either don't experience any or only have mild ones, which are quite manageable. Usually, these side effects get better as your body adjusts to the medicine. Now, common side effects, which happen in more than 1 in 100 people, include headaches, feeling tired, dizzy or weak, having cold hands or feet, feeling sick, and stomach pain. If these bother you or they don't go away after a few days, talk to your doctor or your pharmacist. Now, rarely, metoprolol can cause serious side effects. You should seek medical help immediately if you experience signs of lung problems, so things like shortness of breath and chest tightening, heart problems, such as difficulty breathing, coughing more when exercising, swollen ankles, or an irregular heartbeat, or symptoms of too much thyroid hormone, so this might be a fast heart rate and confusion, as well as signs of liver problems, so yellow eyes or skin, or unusual bruising, which could indicate low platelets in your blood. Now, if you have heavy bleeding that won't stop, or if you experience chest pain that's new, worse, or doesn't stop after a few minutes, get medical help right away, because this kind of chest pain could be a sign of a heart attack. In very rare cases, metoprolol can cause a serious allergic reaction, which is called an anaphylactic reaction. So if you notice swelling in your lips, your mouth, your throat, or your tongue, trouble breathing or swallowing, or changes in skin color, confusion, or if you faint or can't be woken up, or if this happens to someone else who's taking this medicine, call for emergency help immediately, because this could be life-threatening. Remember, this is not a complete list of side effects, and for more details, I suggest you should always check the information leaflet in your medicine packet. Now, often you might be taking other medications in addition to metoprolol, and it's important that we briefly cover this because certain medications can affect how metoprolol works. So if you're taking metoprolol, it's important to tell your doctor about any other medicines that you're using, especially if you're on other high blood pressure medicines, because they could interact with metoprolol and lower your blood pressure too much. This might make you feel dizzy or faint. Now, if this happens often, your doctor might need to adjust your dosage to find the right dose for you. Other medicines that could interact with metoprolol are ones which also lower your blood pressure, like some antidepressants, nitrates for chest pain, muscle relaxants, so things like baclofen, tamsulosin, which you might be taking for an enlarged prostate, and medications for Parkinson's disease, so cocarol-dopa or levodopa. These could cause similar issues. So other medications that could possibly interact with metoprolol in a negative way are non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. These are NSAIDs, so things like ibuprofen, and these may increase blood pressure, so try to use them sparingly. Metoprolol may also make it harder to notice when your blood sugar is low. So if you're taking diabetes medicines and allergy medicines, so things such as ephedrine, noradrenaline or adrenaline, and medications for asthma or COPD, you should use these cautiously and always speak to your doctor before you start taking metoprolol to make sure they think it's okay for you. Finally, mixing metoprolol with herbal remedies and supplements is not recommended. That's because these aren't tested in the same way as regular medicines, so their safety and effects when taken with metoprolol are uncertain. So let's finish off the video with some commonly asked questions. So first of all, some people will ask, how long does it take metoprolol to work? So metoprolol starts to work after about 2 hours, but it can take up to 1 week to take full effect. You may not feel any different when you take the metoprolol, but this does not mean that it is not working. So it's important that you keep taking it. Other people will ask, will it affect my sex life? Now, some people on metoprolol say that their sex drive goes down or they can't get an erection. But this is not a common side effect, and there isn't enough evidence to say for sure that metoprolol causes it. If you're having problems with your sex life, talk to your doctor, please don't be embarrassed, or check out some of the helpful resources that I've posted in the description box of this video. Finally, other people will ask, can I continue to drive? Now, metoprolol can make some people feel dizzy, especially when they first start taking it or after taking a bigger dose. This happens to you, don't drive a car, ride a bike, or use tools or machinery. Remember, it's an offence to drive a car if your ability to drive safely is affected, and it's your responsibility to decide if it's safe to drive. If you're in any doubt, it's always best to err on the side of caution and don't drive. This will avoid putting you and other people in harm's way. And for more information about metoprolol, including specific issues around pregnancy, breastfeeding, and fertility, please check out the reputable links that I've included in the description box of this video. If you've got any questions, please do reach out in the comments section. Please do remember, however, this is an educational video only. It's not a clinical advice video, so I can't give individual answers to individual questions, but rather general advice. If you enjoyed the video, please consider subscribing to the channel for weekly medical education videos. Once again, thanks for watching and bye.